If you saw my previous video, I made a Laura for consistent characters. Images generated by the same Laura are in motion now. And she loves me. This application is simple and easy to understand for making dancing videos. This should also work on 8GB graphic cards as well. The project is named as Control Next. It is using Stable Video Diffusion to generate this image to video. This is not realistic, but if you are looking for a simple interface, then you can try this. Actually, while installing this application, I came across multiple errors and struggled to fix it. In the process, I came across a fork of this project. The fork had detailed installation steps, and it worked. Let's look into it. This is the project folder. I will activate the environment and run the project. Control-click the IP address to open in the browser. As said earlier, simple interface, but it's a different fork. Fork is like making a copy of an existing project and changing it as per our needs. Out of 64 copies, this is the one. The owner updated this fork last week. The credit for detailed instruction goes to this person. I will explain the interface, then the installation process. At the end, I will share my findings, what I understood after using this application. This is where you will upload the image of the character you want dancing. And here you need to upload the video. The output directory, where you will find the result. Inside the project folder, there will be an output directory. Inside there are results. There is an advanced settings block. The maximum frame you want in the result. Let me upload a video. When you upload a video, it will take the total frame automatically. Frame count lower than the uploaded video will decrease the video length. Guidance scale will be adherence to the uploaded media file. Default works fine. Batch frames are about the number of frames to process at a time. Decreasing this should consume less video memory. The explanation I am giving here is based on my experience and knowledge. I searched for the details, but did not found any. These options were kept at default. Height and weight here is about the video's resolution in the result. The button to start the process. While processing, certain output is visible here. It includes the video generation status or any errors. This section contains models and other components, which are used to generate a video. Let's upload an image. It takes around 8 minutes to generate an 8-second video. You will see an output something like this. Then like this. The video memory is above 8GB, but under 12 right now. The batch frame is at default value, which is 20. Let's check the result. I will not say this is amazing, but this is what open source projects can achieve without complex settings. But I am still looking for other applications. So, if you have any suggestions, then do let me know. Next, I will decrease the batch, and will make it from 20 to 10. After decreasing the batch, it is occupying around 8GB of memory. The time to complete the 8-second video has been increased from 8 minutes to 13 minutes. The older result got replaced by the new result. That is why, if you look at other results, I have added a number at the end. If you change the name of the result, it will not be replaced. A new video file will be generated in this folder having the name as output. The video generated looks similar to the previous video. But if we check the properties of this video, frame per second must be lower if compared with other video generated at default settings. With every result, we get one more video file. This is the second file, with the skeleton. Let's look at the installation quickly. Git and Python is required. I created a temporary folder for the application and opened the command prompt. My Python version is 3.10. First will be clone the project. Get into the project folder. Create a Python environment. Activate the environment. Install Wheel. Now install all requirements in the environment. This will take some time. Next is, download the example from the original repository. This is about the demo images and videos. Go to the original repository and download it in a zip format. Open the zip, go to the folder named svd-v2. Copy this folder named example. Paste the example folder copied inside the project folder. Next, we need to create some folders and download some files. Create a folder named pretrained in the project folder. Inside this new folder, there should be a folder named dwpose. Done with folders, now this two files inside dwpose folder. Download both the files. After that, this two files are needed inside pre-trained folder. The pre-trained folder files can be downloaded from here. The folder should look something like this. Next is to clone the stable video diffusion files. Stable Diffusion team may not allow you to get the files without having your information. Make sure to log in into Hugging Face and visit this page. Click Expand to review and access. Fill up the details and submit the form to have access to these files. If you run the copied command and you get a login option like this, then you need to type your Hugging Face ID and password. The files cannot be downloaded without login. You may also see asking for username and password like this. You can type and hit enter while typing password. It may not be visible. You just type and hit enter, even if it looks blank. The third type of response you may encounter here is a 401 error, something similar to unauthorized. To work with that, search for Hugging Face login command. Run this command, this will let you log in. Next, the login command. This will start the login process. It is asking for your Hugging Face token. I showed in one of my previous videos about generating Hugging Face token. Go to Settings, then Access Token. Then create a new token. Name the token. Give permissions to the token. Last, create token. There are things here, but I do not want to show that. Never share your token with anyone. Once it is generated, you will get an option to copy the random text in the left. That is a token. Press Ctrl plus V to paste the token. It will be invisible, you can just hit enter. Press Y to save your token in the computer for the future. Once you get response of successful login, you can run this command. This will be the last command to start the application. Always make sure to activate the environment, then start the application. Control plus click to open in web browser. Let's look at some of the results. If you saw my older videos, I made a Laura for consistent character. This was just for testing, turned out to be a good one. I tried creating motion into those images. The results were good. What I found was, motions showing different angle can spoil the video. Less motion and keeping the character's angle the same as the image gives better results. Body parts and images like this may turn into humans-like. Because this AI is made for creating human characters. Here, the AI was not able to create the rotation of her head. A simple front-facing video could have given better results. Front-facing gives better results, but the face size matters in the entire image. Construction of a small face is a challenge for the application. Simply put, try having a decent size face in image and video. Height does matters. Or else the AI will try matching from the video. The motion video I am using is already generated by AI. I was not able to spend time searching for decent video. A decent video with a stable background does give better results. If we compare the properties of the video generated, videos generated with default batch frame has 15 frames per second. This one generated with batch frame 10 has 7 frames in a second. Make sure to keep the video height and width divisible by 8. Let me know your thoughts about this application. Will you be using this application? Do you have any better application for suggestion?